that's it.
Okay.
So before you start putting water in, make sure that's in that position,
Okay. The
yellow lever. If you want to drain it, all you do is just lift it up into the vertical position and that will drain it out.
Okay.
Along with opening all the taps to centre.
Yeah.
Okay, but obviously put water in, closed. Close all your taps, make sure they're all closed before you switch the water pump on.
Okay.
Because if you go and operate the water pump on before you've closed everything,
water's going to go
in places where you don't want it to go.
So okay. Drain it, all the water taps up, and that's up. So up to and then
it, yeah.
down.
To,
yeah. Okay, I can
that's it.
That.
So they're all closed down.
So I think. Open the taps, drain it,
close the taps to fill it.
So we want to get water in when we use it.
Yeah.
Okay.
That makes sense. Sorry, where am I going now?
Yeah. Okay, so we're going back that way. We're now going to switch the water pump on. The reason why I say close all the taps before, because you can see where that can go.
Yes.
So if that's it over here somewhere,
and
you've left that open to drain
it,
you switch that water pump on, you're going to have water everywhere.
Okay.
Okay, so water pump on, which is all I've already switched on.
Yep.
What you need to do is get the air out of the system, okay?
Okay.
So open the tap, get the air out of the system, which I've already done. To fill your hot water tank, turn it to the hot side of your tap, and you'll get a lot of air coming through there. Because what you've got is 10 litres of air in that tank.
Okay.
If you've drained it. So you obviously want to fill it with 10 litres of water. So 10 litres of air is going to be coming out of there. And once you've got a solid stream like that, that means your hot water tank's full. Okay?
Oh, okay.
Okay, obviously the steam coming off that is not instant heat. Obviously I've had it all set up ready to roll. But normally you would not switch the water heating on until you've got water in there. Okay? So once you've got that solid stream of water, you can switch the tap off. You've then filled your hot water tank. Do the same with each tap. So it gets all the air out of the system.
Okay.
Do you have to do the shower as well?
Yeah, it's best to do them all, because what you've got is an onboard pump, which works on pressure.
Yeah.
If there's air still in the system, it takes that bit longer to squash the air before it stops the pump. If there's water, it'll stop a lot quicker. So the annoyance of, if you've got air in there, the pump will continue for 2 or 3 more seconds. Especially at night time, if someone's opened the tap and shut it again, all you hear is noise going on.
Okay.
It can be quite annoying. Alright. Okay, so to heat the water, so what we've got on the consumer board up here, apart from switches look very similar to that one up there, so you could switch it from here if you wanted to, is this one here. So water heating on electric, that's off, that's on, space heater, there's isolation for electric, okay? So you need to switch for the water heater, switch that on, and then underneath, right next to the water boiler, there's a nice switch hidden, which took me a while to find. Just down here, you see that there? That will switch between two elements, okay? So centre is off, you see that rocker switch, centre is off, up is electric 1, down is electric 2. So it's got two elements running on 2, one element running on 1. Okay, so obviously you want to get the water hotter, then obviously electric 2 is probably the better one to go for. Okay?
Yeah.
Do not make sure that is not switched on with no water in that tank. If that is switched on and that is switched on up there, it's like boiling the kettle with no water in it.
Okay.
It's going to damage the element. Okay?
Okay.
It has got a thermal switch which will shut down.
Yeah.
Obviously, after a few times, that may not work, and then obviously it will damage the element. It may have obviously, this has been a few years old.
Yeah.
It may have already been operated a few times, you don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, so always when you're leaving site, when you're finished, make sure they both of them are switched off. So if you drain your water out as you're traveling home or whatever, you get as long as when you get to your next site, you know them are off. And then you can still check to make sure they're off before you start switching anything
on. Yeah, okay.
Well, I'll leave that switched off for now.
Okay.
So that's
so switch it on the consumer board and then switch it on there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so that will be heating your water on electric. You can operate on gas, which is in a totally different position. Which is this one up here.
Okay.
So it is actually running on electric and gas at the moment. So that's, with the gas side of it, it actually gives you a temperature, 70 degrees or 50 degrees.
Okay.
You can operate on both at the same time if you wanted to get the water boosted up.
Okay, get it got hotter quicker.
Hotter quicker, or you can just use it on electric, or you can just use it on gas.
Okay.
Okay. On the gas side of it, if it fails, you'll see a red light come on.
Yeah.
Okay, an indicator light. That was, it indicates it's failed. The usual reasons for that is one, you haven't turned your gas on. Two, you haven't got any gas. Or three, you've left that cover on.
Yeah.
So that will fail it as well.
Okay.
Or three, there may be air in the system. A lot of people tend to use the water heater on electric. If they've got connected to electric, you pay for your pitch, electric comes with it.
Yeah.
So you just use electric.
It,
If you don't operate on gas very often, it ends up with air in the gas system.
Right, okay.
Okay. So if it fails, switch it off. check all them things, make sure you've got the cover off, make sure you've turned the gas on, and start again. Switch it on again. It may fail again. So it may take two or three attempts. Switch it off again. So what you're actually doing then is trying to purge the air out of the system to get to the gas. Okay?
Yep.
Yeah.
Happy with that?
Yep.
Good. Next one is your room heater. So we're doing it.
Yep.
Water heating. The room heater is the next one. So again, you've got the isolating switch on there, which is next to the water heater, the orange switch.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Which it then comes back to this control here. If you see that says 230 volt.
Yeah.
Ultra heat, that's heating your room. You see that on the switch here?
Yeah.
Heater, ultra heat, heating your room.
I'm doing my
ultra store, stores your water. Okay, so that's your water heater, that's your room heater. Okay, so we switch that isolating button on there. This, you've now got the options when you switch it on of 500, 1000 or 2000 watts. Obviously 2000 being the hottest. And a thermostat in the centre. So if 9's lined up with that 0 there, that means that's the hottest you're going to set it to.
Right.
What it's doing is heating an element up in the fire, which is underneath your wardrobe here. Okay? So that's now heating an element inside there.
Yeah.
Okay, so that'll obviously start warming your van. Obviously, you need to operate the fan as well. Obviously you've got if you look, you've got vents in certain places in your van.
Oh, right, yeah.
So obviously, when you've got heating going, make sure you've got a fan going, because that'll then, push it out.
The air through.
That's it. Okay?
And that can only work when you're not driving, when you're...
Yes. Yeah, you can't...
And you can do it from gas as well?
Yeah, you can also do it with gas. To operate on gas, if you just turn this control here...
Yeah.
You hear the clicking?
Yep.
Yeah, so it's ready to fire up. All you need to do is just press it down.
Okay, and then it would...
If you allow the gas out, it should fire up. There is a window there, which is very difficult to see from this angle. It should be about that angle
and
there.
Be like the pilot light.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
Okay.
But you'll actually see the burner through a small window.
Okay.
Because that window there, you should see it down there. But what you shouldn't do is, as I've obviously got it, don't operate on both electric and gas, because obviously the unit can overheat.
Okay, cool. That's good.
This side of it is your fan. Okay, that's totally independent, runs totally independent from your heating. So you can operate on electric or gas, okay? Or you can operate on its own as well if you want just air to circulate in the summer.
Right.
Okay. Oh, so basically, if it's on gas, that'll still blow the heat around.
Yeah.
If
it's on electric, it will blow it around. If it, even on its own without...
It'll just blow air around.
So what you've got is three settings. Automatic, so that's thermostatic control, so it'll go up and down with the heat.
Yeah.
Manual.
Yeah, and then...
So you can actually change the speed over there, and then... I think that's boost. So that'll just be flat out, warming up quicker.
Okay, cool.
But always have some kind of fan running when you've got... heating running.
Yeah.
Okay, happy with that?
Yeah.
So you're happy?
Are you coming to those in a bit? Or
Yeah. While we're here, then might as well do them.
Well, no, but if there's in the right order...
But obviously while we're here, we might as well do them now. So obviously, there's individual appliances work on gas.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
So that works on gas. So there are individual taps to turn off the gas to each particular box.
Oh,
okay, so these two here, it's got a barbecue written on it. And that one's, if you see that, it's a tap with... what looks like could be steam coming out of it.
I can't see.
So that's one for your boiler and one for your barbecue point, which is on the outside.
Yeah.
You don't really need to turn them on or off, okay?
Okay.
As long as you're turning the gas cylinder off on the outside when you're travelling.
Okay.
This shouldn't be an occasion where you need to turn them off, unless something drastic's happened where something's really dangerous. But the best thing to do, rather than do individual taps, is turn the gas off totally outside.
Yeah. It's just like an isolation valve,
So there will be other ones in the van, which obviously that's just doing them too. There should be one for the fire.
Is there one fire there?
Because they dot them around the place a bit.
Yeah, that's where where they can fit them, isn't
it? That's it, yeah. So as close as the back of the fire will obviously warm it up. And that's obviously the wide angle for your bit outside.
So other than hanging clothes and stuff in there.
Yeah, it's all right to store here. It's underneath there. You don't.
Oh,
want,
I'm sorry. Fine. Down there.
Store the item underneath there. Otherwise, obviously, it's getting quite warm up there.
Yes.
Okay. Right. Your next thing what we've got is your fridge. Right. This will be interesting. If you want to come this side, it'll probably be easier to see.
Yay! Sorry.
Okay. So obviously, you've got a nice blue light inside there. So you've got freezer compartment, fridge compartment. So there's options on how to operate this. So that there is your on-off button. Okay, so you press and hold that, switch it on or off. It's running on gas at the moment. You can switch it so it runs on electric.
Okay.
To fire it on gas, all you do is just press that, and that will fire the gas up. If it fails, it will let you know. What I'll do is just put it on the 12-volt system now. Okay, so that's failure. Okay, so that's failed to detect the energy it's requiring, which that one is 12 volts off your vehicle electrics, not off your leisure battery, because it looks like a battery. It's actually coming from when your engine's running and when you're travelling.
Yeah.
It will actually keep the fridge cool.
Oh, right.
So it won't cool it down. It just maintains the temperature that it's
right.
at.
Right. So that's what you have to put it to when you're travelling?
Yeah, when you're travelling, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. The other thing is, as I said, it won't cool the fridge down, so you need to cool the fridge down before you travel.
Yeah, and then
And then switch it to that.
Right,
and it'll maintain it, obviously, as long as you're not opening and shutting the door too often.
Yeah.
Okay? So if that happens on the gas side of it, that means the gas hasn't lit.
Right.
Okay? So if that fails to light, you've got to go through the system of checking. You've turned your gas on. That crash sensor, which I forgot to mention earlier, make sure that's pushed in. The gas is turned on. You have got gas, so what you could do is light your cooker up.
Yeah.
Make sure you've got gas running. And all you do is just press that hazard button there. Okay, that will reattempt to light it.
Yeah.
It'll be somewhat similar to your boiler. If you've got air in the system, obviously you may have to try and attempt to light it about two or three times.
Okay.
So just put it back to electric. What it's also got on this one is automatic. So if I press that one, that will automatically select the best energy that's available. Okay, so what it thinks is the best energy is if electric first, so as long as that's connected, it will go for that. If no electric's present, it will then go for gas.
Oh, that's good.
If the gas is not present, it will then go for 12 volt.
Okay.
Which is 12 volt off your vehicle.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. It's now making a noise at us because obviously someone's left the door open.
Yeah.
Okay.
Which so would you recommend leaving it on that automatic?
You can. It's totally up to you. Totally up to you. You can just put it on the electric. If you don't want to use your gas.
Yeah.
And it, all of a sudden, you've got to switch it off, and you've left it on gas. It will automatically want it to start up on gas.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So it's up totally up to you, obviously, there's that option there. Okay. This side of it is, you see all these five bars lit? That's the coldest the fridge is going to be. Obviously, the freezer is different. So if it's coming out frozen butter out your fridge, then obviously it's too cold.
Yeah.
Reduce it down a bit. Obviously, it depends on the temperature outside. If it's really hot outside, it's obviously going to need to work harder.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Then,
and what's that one?
And that one there?
Yep.
That is to do with the freezer box.
Okay.
Okay, so obviously in the summer you can get a bit of condensation around here.
Yeah.
And that can end up freezing the door shut.
Yeah.
Okay. That is there. You press that on and it will actually warm the edge of the door.
Okay. Well, that's clever.
So it'll release the door. Okay.
Wish you did that at home.
Yeah. Obviously you end up full of ice.
Okay, cool. Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
That?
Yep.
Good. Oh, what? One thing also. These contraptions here. Okay, what that's for is when you're in storage, it actually operates off the door mechanism itself, and that keeps the door ajar so air can circulate around to stop it going mouldy. Okay, just make sure it is fully in when you use it, because obviously if it's not fully in, it's not going to seal, then you're going to be ringing up saying the fridge doesn't work.
Yeah.
To
get it out, you need to more or less put pressure on it to force it against the wall as such, and then slide it towards you.
Okay,
and it just slides back. Same with the bottom door as well.
So when we leave it, because we're going to be leaving it here when we're not using it.
Yeah.
So when we park it up, just
pull make sure it's clean, because even a small blob of milk left in it, obviously you're going to end up with a nice blue fuzz ball.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, cool. Lovely.
Okay, cool,
Fridge. Yeah,
cool.
Sorry.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
So talk of the opposite cooker. Ooh. 12 volt igniter there. So as I said before, when we come in, obviously you need to switch them on, because obviously there's a lot of 12 volts. It, 12 volt ignites that. There's 12 volt will ignite your gas, your boiler.
Yeah.
So there's always 12 volts running somewhere, even though the 240 will be supplying electric to boost that. Okay, so all you do is just press and hold until it lights up.
Yep.
Okay, just checking to see if this has got a... No, it hasn't. So this hasn't got a safety device on the lid. So be very careful you're not putting it down when it's still lit, because obviously that will go bang.
It'll go crack, yeah.
Yeah, you'll be in trouble. And then grill. Same igniter button again.
Where's the gas coming from?
Outside.
There's a pipe outside.
Oh, I was going to say.
Yeah, I've supplied. Yeah, it's coming off our supply at the
moment. Okay, fine. I thought I was going mad.
Okay, and then obviously you've got your handle in there.
Yeah.
And your oven.
That's fab. Yeah, no, that's good. All good.
Good. Right, you have obviously got electric one as well.
Yeah.
Which is quite good, because that's got an indicator light there.
Okay.
Until you left it on. Right, this one here is what's called an eco microwave. Press the eco button there to show you there that to wake it up. Okay, so after a certain amount of time, it will shut itself off, obviously, if you're not using it. Big button opens it. Do not travel with glass plate in, because if that comes bouncing out and drops onto there, expensive. Okay, so I'll just need that there for now. My wife tends to put it in the bowl with a tea towel, so it'll stop it
that. Yeah, that's a good idea, yeah.
Okay, what you've got, that's fairly straightforward. If you want 10 minutes or 1 minute or seconds, you just press them and away it goes.
Yeah.
Okay,